Oh, look at that. That is nice. Worth the 135 steps, I tell you. You see the big one? The big one comes up here, that's it. Oh, that was weird. All right, definitely has to be on the list, Kambughai Falls. This is a must if you come to Siquijor. It's such a cool place. I mean, aside from the 135 steps going up and down, which can really give you a workout, once you get down there, totally, totally worth it. Plus, you see so many people there. That's probably the most people we've seen so far. Foreigners, tourists, etc., gathering in one place. Maybe it's the hour, I don't know. I think it's the attraction because it's just fun. It's just like this big nature's pool. You know, you got these swings going on and it's just, anyway, you gotta do it. That's the point. And then after that, head to where we're heading. Baja Bar is a real special place here in Siquijor. They do their own sausages, they do their own bread, and they have their own microbrewery. I'm driving, so you're not gonna get any beer drinking from me. It's gonna be totally just the food and the ambiance, and that is just down the road, a little bit over here. Nice thing is nothing's too far away from each other over here. You're always within, I don't know, 15, 20 minutes from any point on the island. No traffic and just a great road ahead. Another cool thing about all the new Nissan vehicles, and the patrols got it as well, is the Nissan intelligent mobility solutions that they have over here. Part of it is this, where you've got this wraparound 360 degree view. Well, look at the wheels, look at the wheels. Ta-da, ta-da, the wheels are turning. Yep, so you can literally see around corners from above, a bird's eye view. Of course, it's still safe and wise to look around as well, but really, this here will pretty much address every angle that you could possibly hit, so you can avoid it too. Now, another challenge with these big SUVs is, well, they are supremely comfortable in a straight line, but once you get to the twisties, this is normally the curse because they're so big, and what makes them so comfortable, their weight, the soft suspension on the straights, actually go against you when you're on the curbs. This is why Nissan have employed hydraulic body motion control into the Nissan Patrol, because it needs to be able to stabilize the body. So when you're on the roads like this, like we're gonna turn into this, it's beautiful, it's just settled. You don't feel the weight of the car being thrown on you, like here comes another one. It's a pretty tight curve. We're going downhill as well. This is normally when you'd feel all the weight shift, and somehow the driver tends to absorb all that because you're almost compensating, like holding the wheel, like pulling it back, like, come on, come on, stay in the black stuff, come on. But this thing does it kind of magically. It's the way it keeps the body in line. You don't feel seasick, you don't feel too much movement in the car. It's firm but fair. I like that. Another thing you're gonna absolutely love about this is the interior of this car. I mean, look at the way they've set it up. Just sitting in it feels like a yacht, and that's actually by design, because you notice that the whole dashboard here has that same sort of circular effect that you'll get on those big, beautiful boats that wrap around here especially. So you've got this whole sense that you're in a very, very refined cabin. Then they stuff it with only the best stuff. You've got a Bose sound system over here, which sounds absolutely incredible. I mean, you feel like you have your own concert in the car. You've got the sunroof, of course, just to let in a bit of light. The seats are just maybe an inch or so short of a lazy boy. I mean, this thing is supremely comfortable. I mean, you feel like you could just be in this commanding position. You don't feel like you're driving a car, you feel like you're running a country from here. But one of the greatest features about the Nissan Patrol that you won't see in the brochure is nothing. And I mean that by sound. Like, listen, we're doing 80 kilometers an hour on a provincial road. You can't hear anything. It's dead quiet in here. I mean, this is like a little vault. It's like it's been carved from one solid block of titanium. That's how safe it feels inside. It's almost eerie. It's like this is a whole different universe inside this cabin. Another misconception with the Nissan Patrol is ever since it started getting a little bit social, is that it's no longer capable. I mean, I can see why people would think that. I did too, because I was thinking when you went from like the Safari Patrol, that was like the official PSG type of vehicle. From there, it started getting kind of sort of softer. They rounded the edges off and stuff like that. But they never lost the ruggedness. And I mean, while we're not doing any 4x4 stuff here today in Siquijor, I've taken this thing recently to Morocco. I've driven across the entire deserts of, well, not the entire. I don't think anyone can drive the entire deserts of Morocco. That's huge. But I've driven across various deserts in Morocco, mountains. I've gone through Oman in this thing. We're talking deep sandboxes and heavy duty river crossings and stuff. And this thing doesn't just keep up with the best of them. It actually sets the pace. It sets the standard. They never lost any of that because that's part of the DNA of a Nissan Patrol. It's worth nothing if it doesn't retain that toughness. If you've ever been stuck in traffic and wish you could just fly right over it, Siquijor, they got you, man. Well, that wraps up our little spin around Siquijor. Really small island, but you know what they say about small things, right? Great things come in small packages, and Siquijor is the perfect example of that. You see, they managed to pack in world-class destinations within, what, 15 minutes from each other? And that's thanks to, of course, the really good road network that they have here. Thumbs up, DPWH. And that's exactly what we wanted to showcase over here. We wanted to show you just how accessible the island is, and once you're here, just how easy it is to get around. Because that's what's important, is being able to sort of see as much as you can in as short a time as you can, so you can continue to keep exploring. And sure, you can rent a motorcycle. They've got plenty of them here. You can go around the island. But you know what? If you're more than, let's say, a couple of people, you want the right vehicle. Because with the right vehicle, you can pretty much go anywhere.